Tôi là bác sĩ Vũ Ban, xin kính chào toàn thể quý vị khán thính giả của đài truyền hình VTV 55.2. Chúng tôi hân hạnh được đón tiếp ngày hôm nay một vị ra tranh cử chức dân biểu tiểu bang Texas đơn vị 26, đó là ông Rick Miller. Rick Miller, please say hello to our audience.
Chào quý vị, tôi là Rick Miller.
Well, it's very well said in Vietnamese.
I'm learning.
Okay, good. Rick Miller, I'm glad that you come to our station for a talk show because we have a very good reception last night. Is that right?
We had a wonderful reception. Thank you very much for being there.
Okay. People want to know you before they vote for you. So can you tell a little bit about your background? First, as a conservative, why you say you are conservative?
Well, there are many reasons why I think I am a conservative. One is from a social perspective, a very strong family man, strong family values. And from a fiscal, a spending perspective, less government spending. And so that'll be very important to me when I go to the legislature. And then from a government perspective, less government intervention in our lives, and less regulation, those kinds of things, so that we can build our businesses and allow businesses to grow and prosper, and our people as well.
Vâng, thưa ông Miller, ông nói ông là một người bảo thủ là vì ông sẽ giảm cái sự chi tiêu và ông ấy cố gắng làm sao chúng ta có nhiều những cơ hội để có công ăn việc làm và để phát triển. Vâng. My next question is, you are a veteran. Can you tell us a little bit what you were in the military?
Yes, I was in the United States Navy. I graduated from the United States Naval Academy, and then I went into naval aviation. I was a pilot in the Navy. I flew airplanes off carriers. And so I did that for through various assignments for 30 years in the Navy.
How long have you been in the Navy? How long?
I was in the Navy actually a total of 34 years if you count my 4 years at the Naval Academy, and in 30 years of active duty service.
Vâng, thưa quý vị, ông Rick Miller, ông là một cựu quân nhân. Ông đã phục vụ trong hải quân, nhưng mà ông lại là một người lái phi cơ, nó gọi là Navy Pilot, và ông đã làm trên hàng không mẫu hiệm và hàng không mẫu hạm, và đồng thời ông ấy đã phục vụ trong quân đội, tức là trong hải quân 34 năm. Well, you have a very good background, and also you are, after that you are a businessman. Can you tell us about your background on businessman?
Yes, when I transitioned out of the military, out of the Navy, I worked for several public companies, and then I started my own business in the leadership area, where I work with businesses or churches or even military organizations on developing the leadership within their organization. That's my business.
Do you have a business of your own?
It's my own business right now. Yes, it's small business. And
what kind of business? If I'm asking you, what kind of business?
Well, it's like, again, I contract with organizations to go to them and work with their people to develop them as leaders. That's I develop people as leaders, and I help also developing their planning, their strategic planning, and developing their teamwork, that kind of thing. That's what I do with organizations.
Vâng, tức là ông làm cái người mà giúp người ta thực hiện những cái chương trình của họ, và ông ấy làm trong nhiều những cái địa vị về xây cất cũng như là về những về chùa chiền hay là về những công tác dân sự. My next question is, you involved a lot in community service. Can you tell us about your involvement into the community service?
Sure. I am a member of a Rotary Club in Sugar Land, and I have been involved in leading or chairing as chairman veterans tributes to our veterans over the past several years. We've done three of those veterans tributes, I have served on the City of Sugar Land Airport Advisory Board as a naval aviator. I understand the airport system and the airplanes and that kind of thing. And then I've been involved in the political arena with the Republican Party. I also am strongly involved in my church. I served as the finance committee chairman for our church in a large budget, and so I have that experience as well.
Vâng, thưa quý vị, ông Rick Miller nói rằng ông ấy rất hoạt động trong cái cộng đồng của ông đang sống. Ông là một thành viên của một cái hội gọi là Rotary Club. Thưa quý vị, Rotary Club là một cái hội phục vụ xã hội lớn thứ nhì trên thế giới sau hội Lions Club. Because I am a Lions.
Okay.
And so I know about Rotary is a service organization.
Yes.
Là ông ấy làm những cái việc mà cái mục đích của hội Rotary là phục vụ. Thưa quý vị, ngoài ra ông còn giúp tất cả những chùa chiền, tất cả những công việc cộng đồng. Vì thế mà người ta gọi ông là cái người gọi là community activist, tức là người hoạt động rất nhiều ở trong cộng đồng. And the last but not the least, you are a family man. Can you tell us about your family?
Absolutely. My wife and I were married in right after I graduated from the Naval Academy. Mm-hmm. And so we just recently celebrated our 44th mm-hmm. wedding anniversary. Mm-hmm. And so we're very very happy, and we work together well. We're partners in this process. We have three children. Mm-hmm. Our oldest child is a pilot in the Navy. Mm-hmm. He also went to the Naval Academy, mm-hmm. and he's kind of doing the same things that Dad did. Mm-hmm. And so he's still doing that. Our middle son is a lawyer here in the Houston area. He went to the University of Texas Law School, and he's a lawyer here locally. And then our youngest child passed away when he was 4 years old. He had leukemia and he passed away. So he's with the Lord.
So you are lucky to have a very nice family.
Yes.
And I think most of people want to have someone of your gender to follow your path. Like you are Navy pilot, then you have one son.
One son who followed in my footsteps.
That you are blessed, because most people cannot achieve that goal.
Well, he did, but he's making his own path and he's doing his own thing, and we're very proud of all three of our children.
Wow, that's it. So basically he's a veteran serving in the Army. He's also a conservative. He's a community activist and he's a family man. Thưa quý vị, đấy là ông ấy là ba cái địa hạt. Là thứ nhất, ông ấy là một cái người đã làm cựu quân nhân. Thứ hai, ông ấy là một cái người hoạt động cộng đồng. Thứ ba, ông là một người ở trong một cái gia đình rất là quý báu, có một cái liên hệ gia đình rất là tốt. Ông ấy lấy bà vợ này hơn 30 năm và ông có ba người con. Một người thì làm Navy pilot, tức là phi công trong hải quân như ông. Một người thì là luật sư, và đấy là những cái điều mà ông Nguyên nói với chúng tôi. My next question is how you involved in politics and why you choose to be a representative in the Texas House, because you have more options, right?
I have some, but I'm remiss because I forgot to mention my three lovely grandchildren. So we have three grandchildren. Mm-hmm. Our oldest son, the Navy pilot. They have three children, so we have three beautiful grandchildren that we're very proud of.
Vâng, ông vừa nói rằng ông nói thêm rằng ông có ba người cháu rất là dễ thương. Vâng, my question is why you involved in politics and why you choose to be representative of Texas House at District 26. Can you tell me how?
Okay. Well, I was serving as the party chairman, Republican Party chairman, and then looking at perhaps did that for 4 years, and so we looked at what might be some other options for me to serve and to serve the people and serve our constituents there in Fort Bend County, and looked at several options, but my good friend Charlie Howard, who is the current state representative. When he decided not to run again, then my wife and I and some other close friends, we talked about that, And we decided that the best thing for me to do is, would to serve the people in the state, in the Texas State House. And so that's why we decided to run for the Texas State House.
Vâng, thưa quý vị, tôi hỏi ông là tại sao ông mới lại chọn cái địa vị là dân biểu của tiểu bang Texas, đơn vị 26. Vì ông ấy nói rằng là ông có một người bạn mới xong cái nhiệm kỳ làm dân biểu, thì ông thấy có một cái chỗ như thế có thể hợp với ông ấy, và đồng thời ông cái sự khuyên răn của người bạn của ông là nên tranh cử vào cái chức vụ này, và sau cùng là ông ấy nói rằng là ông ấy muốn phục vụ cho những người dân của cái vùng mà ông đang sống. Wow.
Well, I think also because I really care about my country, because I served my country for 30 years in the military. Well, I also care about Texas. I believe our country is the greatest country on the earth. And I believe Texas is the greatest state in the union. And so I wanted to again serve to keep Texas a great state. That's one of the that's probably the primary reason I decided to do that.
Yeah.
Okay.
Thưa ông ấy còn nói rằng ông ấy rất là yêu quê hương, yêu nước Mỹ, và đồng thời ông ấy muốn phục vụ cho cái tiểu bang Texas, vì ông muốn đây là cái tiểu bang mà ông thấy rằng cũng như là một cái nước mà có thể là nhất trên thế giới. Vì thế mà ông mới giải ứng cử chức dân biểu tiểu bang Texas, đơn vị 26. Well said. Now, if you are elected in that position of a representative of the House, a Texas House, what your objective, what your aim, what do you plan to do for in that position?
Okay, my first priority would be to represent the citizens of my district the best I can. And so I want to be their voice in Austin. I want to know what their issues are, and I want to carry those issues to Austin so that I am their representative, be they Republicans or Democrats or whoever. I want to represent them and be their voice. And there are many issues that are facing Texas today.
What are those issues?
Oh my goodness. Well, if we're going to keep Texas great, one of probably the most important thing is the education of our children.
Mm-hmm.
And providing an education system that whatever the state needs to do to help in that process. I do think though that that a lot of these issues with our cities and our school boards are local issues. And so I would support the local issues as well as being involved from a state perspective.
Vâng, thưa quý vị, ông Miller nói rằng là ông ra tranh cử thì ông mới trước hết là ông muốn đại diện cho cái cộng đồng mà ông ấy đang sống, tức là Fort Bend, và đồng thời ông mới đưa những cái ước vọng của những cái người dân đang sống ở Fort Bend tới cái hạ viện của Texas. Đồng thời ông muốn đưa tất cả những cái sự mà ông ấy muốn là ông muốn có một cái nền giáo dục tốt hơn cho Texas, cũng như là tất cả những cái gì nguyện vọng mà những dân Texas muốn ông ấy thực hiện ở trong Hạ viện. Vâng, now you cover most of the issue. Anything else you want to tell about our audience, like the property tax, for example? Is it in Texas particularly? The property tax is very high. How are you going to reduce the property taxes?
Well, I've been talking with various other legislators about this, about coming up with a plan that perhaps we can reduce our property tax. And in order to do that, we are going to have to figure out resources so that we can, because the property tax mostly goes into our school system.
Mm-hmm.
And so if we're going to reduce our property tax, what are we going to do to replace that so that we're providing adequate resources to the school system? And there are some things that we're thinking about. I'm not ready to talk about that right now, but perhaps some things within the sales tax arena, that area. But we don't have the plan worked out yet. But the objective would be to make the property tax as low as we can make it. And then, but we also have to make sure that we're providing the resources to support our teachers and our school system, but the teachers primarily, because their focus is on the student. We want to educate our children the best that we can and make them leaders in the future. They're our future leaders.
Good. Thưa quý vị, ông Miller nói rằng ông chú trọng về giáo dục, về những thầy giáo, những học sinh của chúng ta, làm sao để chúng ta có thể, để sau các cái con em của chúng ta có thể thành những người lãnh đạo. Vì thế mà ông ấy, ngoài ra ông còn lo vấn đề làm sao hạ được cái tiền thuế về thổ trạch. Thưa quý vị, như quý vị cũng biết rằng ở Texas cái tiền thổ trạch rất là cao. Thì ông nghĩ rằng trước khi muốn hạ cái thuế đó thì chúng ta phải kiếm cái tiền nào để chúng ta có thể bù đắp vào chỗ đó. Well, that we cover most of the issue you want to talk about. You have 2 minutes left. Do you think anything else you want to talk to our audience?
Well, I would appreciate your support. I thank you for this opportunity, Dr. Vu, to have me here and to ask me questions and let me respond to them. I would ask that you consider voting for me. I think I am the right person at the right time for this job, and I will be a full-time representative for the people of my district, for the people of Fort Bend County, and for the people of Texas. So I would ask for your vote, and that's very critical because we have to get people out to vote in the runoff election, which is coming up July 23 to 27, early voting, and then July 31st is the election day. So I would appreciate your vote, and thank you again, sir.
Thưa quý vị, ông ấy nói rằng ông ấy mong được quý vị bỏ phiếu cho ông ấy vào cái ngày từ ngày 23 là bỏ phiếu trước, và cái ngày bỏ phiếu mà chính thức là ngày 31 để ông có thể đại diện cho những người dân ở Fort Bend. Do you know how many Vietnamese probably in Fort Bend County?
Well, I have heard that there are probably several thousand. And so if we can get several thousand Vietnamese out to vote for Rick Miller, then I think we have a very good chance of winning. So I would appreciate if you get those several thousand to the polls.
Thưa quý vị, chúng tôi nói rằng ở Fort Bend thì chúng ta có một vài ngàn người Việt Nam mà có thể đi bầu, và ông Rick Miller mong rằng quý vị sẽ bỏ phiếu cho Rick Miller vào ngày 31 tháng 7 tới đây. Thank you so much for coming and to tell our audience.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Who you are and what is your position if you are elected to be a rep for Texas House.
Thank you.
Interesting.
Thank you very
Thank
much.
Thank you for coming.
You're welcome. Thank you, sir.